Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Harshita Pasha here. Today I'm here to show you my study tour and I'm also here to give you certain tips of how to organize your study space. So let us first, I just want to give you an overview of how my study looks. And then I'll be going to each part to show you how I've organized my study space. Okay, so let's get into the video. The first thing is I do have a rack in here. So the rack has a lot of sections. It has six sections. So each section has books in it. So I'll just tell you how I have organized my study space. So the first thing is I've kept in the first rack, I've kept all my textbooks. I'm a law student, so I prefer to keep all my textbooks in one of the racks. So this is my taxation law textbook, professional ethics, Oxford law, labor law, jurisprudence, code of criminal procedure, code. All random law papers are in here. Just stuffed all random law papers in here. And also I've kept all my scanners in there. So I've just made separate space for my textbooks and separate space for my scanners. So my scanners is in the next rack, in the next section. I have notebooks in the next section too. The last section I've kept all random books which I don't use, which I use it very rarely, like the modern economic theory, the dictionaries, cost accounting, management accounting, lot of books what I had. And then after that, again the third rack is of all random books, random stuff, World of Facts, Facts Factory, certain story books, Bible, all of those. And then after that, my sister's a CS, so she has organized the space. Basically, she's also a law student, so she has company law, capital markets and securities, company accounts, all of those. The third space is again of all random books. We have certain diaries to write down our memos. She has a book, a CA, cup of my cup of tea. She's also doing a CA, so she has that one of that book to inspire her. And then after that, in the last section, we do have all our medals, all our cups, what we got it in our schooling. I was a scout and guide. I was also a debater, so all my debating cups, all my medals are out here. Now let's go to my study space. So always try to keep your study space organized and clean and give a lot of space so that you sit and work in there. So yeah, here you go. This is my study space. And always remember to keep a softboard beside your study space so that if you have any important memos, you can just stick it up on your study space, beside your study space, so that you don't forget to do that thing. So I have my newsletter. Right now I don't have any of my important memos because I just recently completed one of my semesters. So I have East Point Herald. That's one of the thing what I always keep on my softboard. This is my newsletter. I made this newsletter in my college, so this is always there. I was the editor. So, and then after that I have a lot of random papers. I tutor for a lot of schools like Baldwin's, DPS, Charles, Marathi Vidyalaya, Patel Public School. So for all their papers, since March is the month where they are final exams approaching in March, I've asked them to just stick all these memos so that I can just plan stuff for them. And then beside my table, I just beside me I have a photo frame. This is my graduation day. This is one of the most best important moments of my life when I launched the magazine. One of the bestest moments of my life, in fact. These are all my teachers and few of my friends. So love you, Sam John. So love you, Peter. So love you, Rupa ma'am. I think you guys have been a big support of my life, and they are definitely a big part of my life, even though I just graduated from there. And then I do have my printer. So if I have to print out and if I have to print out or something, I just go on my printer, copy, scan, all of those. My whiteboard, so I do take my YouTubing here, YouTube videos here. I do have duster and markers and one pencil. After that, I do have diaries. I have space for my diaries. I am a writer, so I just do write all my random stuff in this. And also a lot of random planning out is there in it. And then after that, I do have a lot of files in it. I do have again a lot of files. I do have space for newspapers. I've just kept all my newspapers. Remember to keep a space for newspapers. If not, just make some space for newspapers. And then always remember to keep a bin beside your table, so that if you have any waste papers, you can throw it in the bin and not on the floor. Or if you have any sharpener shells, or if you have any kind of waste things, you can immediately throw it into the bin, so that you can keep your room more organized. After that, I do have a computer chair, so I sit and work most of the time on this computer chair. Even if I have to take my tutorials, I'm on this chair for the most of the time. So let's get into the drawer. So this is my drawer. I have a lot of stuff in here. I have calculators, I have board pins, calculators, board pins. I do have stapler, I do have stapler pins, binder clips, stencil, a cash memo book, because if I get my fees, I just need to write it down there. Cello tapes, all of those. All my stationery supplies, I've just filled it in these mini boxes. The first thing is, I have a few stationery supplies in this. I was a fan of stationery. I used to collect a lot of stationery. Since I've graduated and I'm doing my post-graduation, I stopped collecting all the random stuff. Dorms erasers, scented erasers, a lot of random stuff I've just filled in. And after that, I do have a pink box in here. So I've kept all stuff in here. So I have red pen, I have black pens, packets, I have a lot of random stuff in here, certain colored pens, glitter pens, all of those. Again, I have a lot of pencils and other things. So I just try to fill in stuff. And then after that, I do have a blue box in which I've kept, I think, sketch pens again, color pencils, post-its, all of those. I'm no more a school student or no more a college going student. I do go to college, but it's post graduation, so I don't require stationery so much, so I've not collected so much stationery. Beside my study table, I do have a bed space. So if people, there are certain family members who come and read or spend time here. What I prefer is, if you want to study, don't study on the bed space, because if you study on the bed space, you feel grumpy and you feel lazy. So always remember to study on the study space, or do study on the chairs, or you can also study on the floor. Studying on the floor is one of the best things. And then after that, I do have charts stuck up here. So because I'm a tutor, I do require charts. I have Kannada Hindi charts, so it's lying out there. And this is my balcony view. This is how my balcony looks. So always remember, keep your study space where there's a lot of ventilation and air coming in. Keep it neat, keep it organized, so that you can stay positive and you can feel fresh when you're coming to the study space and study. If you like this video, please do press the like button, and please do subscribe our channel for more and more videos. Thank you.